Hello, I'm Graham Steele, CEO and co-founder of Cryptosense, and today I'm going to talk to you about post-quantum cryptography. What is it and why do we need it? So a quantum computer is a computer that relies on quantum level phenomena to function. Instead of having bits that flip to 1 and 0, it has qubits which are in a kind of composite entangled state, and that's what does the computation in a completely different way from the way that we do computations right now. These computers will be able to do a whole bunch of interesting things and help us solve a whole kind of problem that is really difficult to solve with classical computers. But they have a nasty side effect from a security point of view, which is that if we can build a big enough quantum computer, we'll be able to break almost all the cryptography that's in use today using public key cryptography. So asymmetric crypto, where I have public keys for some parties and private keys for other parties. This kind of cryptography is used everywhere. It's used every time we set up a TLS connection on the web between a client and a server to protect data. It's used to sign documents. It's used for all kinds of things which are really critical for our infrastructure. So were a computer like this to be built and ready, all kinds of catastrophic things could happen, like I could force malicious code updates into your computer, for example, and pretty much take it over. So we know that we need to replace the cryptography that we use today, particularly for asymmetric cryptography, before these machines are built, and we need to replace it with something that will resist those kinds of quantum computers. And it's even more serious than that, because already the exchanges of data that are happening today based on keys that are established by asymmetric cryptography, things like Diffie-Hellman key establishment and so on, these could be broken in the future by a quantum computer. So an adversary now could be recording our exchanges in order to decrypt them in 10 or 20 years time when a big size quantum computer is available, and then read all our data. So data that still has to be secret, so medical data, this kind of stuff that we still want to keep critically secret in 10 or 20 years time, we should already be thinking about how we're going to protect that from quantum computers. So the good news is that smart cryptographers are already working on this problem, coming up with new algorithms and finding out whether they resist quantum computers and whether these new algorithms resist the attacks by classical computers. There's a big competition being organized by NIST, the American Standardization Authority, that is putting forward candidates and breaking them and whittling them down to a short list, and will soon, perhaps in 2022, 23, 24, announce the winners. And a new set of algorithms will be available, and we can start working on fast implementations and getting them really battle tested. The problem is that those algorithms for the moment are still pretty new. So we don't know which ones of those are necessarily going to win the competition. So already they're whittled down to a shortlist, but it's hard to know how that's going to go. And we've never had to work on eliminating the kind of rough edges of these algorithms like we have with traditional public key cryptography. So, for example, the RSA algorithm that is used for a lot of public key crypto is very old now. It goes back to the end of the 1970s. And during the time that it's been used, the 80s and 90s, several vulnerabilities came up, not in the maths, but in the way that the algorithm was used. And slowly we hammered those away, so things like timing attacks, power consumption attacks, all this kind of stuff, until we had a really good idea of how to implement this algorithm in a secure way. But we're going to have to start from scratch, more or less, doing that with these post-quantum algorithms. So we've got a lot of hard work to do to really get those things working. So they're not exactly ready for prime time right now. On top of that, if you want to use these algorithms, it's not going to be a simple push button replace where I take out my RSA and replace it with the new algorithm. There's going to be different algorithms that are going to be suitable for different use cases. And so you're going to have to figure out where you can make a trade-off in terms of the size of your keys, the size of your messages, maybe the execution time, what kind of properties that use of the cryptography really needs to stay secure in order to make your choice of what algorithm to put in. But, you know, more people are working on this, the more it's becoming clear what kind of use cases need what kind of replacement, and this is starting to get ready. So should you be in a panic about post-quantum crypto right now if you're running an organization's cryptography strategy? Well, I would say no. But what you should do is start to prepare yourself for what kind of work will be necessary to make that migration. So a good first step for this is making what we call a cryptography inventory. So not just the list of certificates that you use that you probably already have, not just a list of the keys that are in your hardware security modules, you probably already have one of those, but an inventory of all the keys and all the cryptography you use in your organization, in third party, in vendor stuff, in your old legacy stuff, really figure out what it is that you're going to have to replace where when this comes along. The benefit of doing that is you'll already win a whole bunch of benefits from doing that right now. So you'll probably find some old insecure cryptography that you can get rid of. You'll probably find data that you're not actually encrypting that maybe you thought you were that we can start fixing. Maybe certificates that are hidden around the place that are about to expire that we can find out about. So getting your cryptography under management in an automated way has a whole bunch of immediate good benefits for you. And it puts you in the right place to be ready for post-quantum cryptography migration once we're starting to see more clearly which are the winning algorithms, we're getting good standard implementations, and we're ready to go ahead and do that. So you can find out a whole bunch about cryptography inventory, how to do it here on the channel. We've also got a blog article about post-quantum crypto coming out where you can follow some references and really find out the details of what's going on there. Don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date with cryptography here on CryptoSense, and I'll see you again soon.